I'm gonna start this video with something controversial. Visual effects are gonna make your life easier. Are they easy to learn? No. Are VFX artists on high demand? Yes. You have no idea how many job offers I get on a monthly basis. From indie studios to AAA studios, it's crazy out there. Let's forget the high and obscure concepts that revolve around making visual effects for games for a moment. And let's think, what if you could make a living out of it? What if you could actually find a job as a VFX artist? Wouldn't you take it? Like I said, I've refused tons of work from all kinds of studios, big ones, small ones, because I wanted to follow my dream. I then eventually realized that making a game company was my true dream, and that's what I did. I eventually created one. The only thing I'm trying to say is that visual effects enabled me to do this. By the way, if you want to search for the game company I've founded, it's Golden Bug Studios, links below or Google it. So why wouldn't you learn visual effects for games? Why would you? I mean, first, if you are a game developer, it will make your life easier, because that obscure part of game development, it's going to be a little bit brighter at least. You are going to learn how to make your games a little bit more beautiful. Because visual effects is all about designing, thinking, planning, and game development is the same. A little bit harder, but it's the same. And when you come to the part of visual effects, at least you will have that knowledge. The second reason, it's because you can actually get a job in the gaming industry, in a AAA studio or in a smaller studio, but it will be always a very interesting job and on high demand. So how would you find a job in the gaming industry as a VFX artist? Well, it all comes down to creating a portfolio, putting yourself out there, show what you can do. And you might say, but it is hard to learn VFX for games, Gabriel. What can I do? Fortunately, that big mystery around making visual effects for games, special effects for games, has been recently demystified, in a part thanks to my tutorials. Modesty apart, but they have helped few people actually. And especially thanks to my VFX courses, which focus on creating much more complex effects from step to step, and that eventually helped even more artists. As a matter of fact, it has recently hit 30,000 students, which I think it's a very interesting mark. And my channel hit 100,000 subscribers. So at least I think I'm doing something right, right? Well, fortunately nowadays I can say that I've helped few people around the world. People like you, that eventually got a job in the gaming industry. And they never thought it was possible. And I'm not bragging or something like that, I just think it's amazing to be able to help another human being develop his professional career, especially in game development, which is so hard to get in, especially when you are outside and you want to get into this area. And that's so humble, that's so nice. It's one of the most rewarding feelings I get whenever I receive a message from someone saying, well, thank you, I actually got a job as a VFX artist junior on this company or that company, and it makes all the hard work totally worth it. It makes all those weekends working on getting a tutorial ready for Tuesday, they are totally worth it. And that's thanks to messages like that that keep me motivated, and it's one of the reasons I keep pushing these tutorials, pushing these videos as a VFX artist. To see people like you in a VFX position at an indie game company or at a AAA company. And it's not impossible, I've seen it quite a few times, and it's amazing. So why wouldn't you take that opportunity to learn visual effects? Because let's face it, creating magic for games or explosions for games, it's awesome. And that's why you should learn how to create visual effects for games. Because you are going to be a better game developer, indie game developer, if you are an indie game solo developer, which is awesome and hardworking, and visual effects is always that hard part of development. And because you can eventually get a job in the gaming industry as a VFX artist or as a tech artist. I'm not saying it's easy, But it's a little bit easier thanks to my tutorials, I hope at least, and thanks to my courses. But remember, nothing comes out without hard work, patience and lots of practice, and an incredible amount of curiosity that you keep on feeding, because you have to keep on learning in this field as a VFX artist or as a programmer or as a level designer, anything that involves technology. Nowadays you keep on learning, you gotta keep that curiosity really high. But it's possible for you to grow a career in game development as a VFX artist. So I hope that this video motivates you a little bit more to keep on learning, to keep on pushing, and to keep on watching my tutorials on the channel. So that's it for today's video. This is a new format that I'm trying. Let me know if you like it, if you enjoy this. It's always going to revolve around the theory of visual effects. I've created a new playlist, by the way. And let me know if you want to see more things like this. And these videos are also possible thanks to my patrons, where they get access to an awesome library of visual effects that they can study up close or use them in their games. So thank you for supporting me last month, and as usual, a quick shout out to the top tier patrons, which are 3D Sorcery, Alexander Brazy, Achilles Benitez, Aviat Tobali, Avid VR, Baz, Christopher Vivas, Krubidubidu, Cyber Cradle, Daniel Schmidt, Diaku, Diego Marques, Duitron, Effect Yellow, El Sheriff, Fang Striker, Gio, Goblin Plague, Guilherme Trindade, Jairo Garcia, Casey Miller, Christophe Chamiai, Leon Holt, Lemu, Letuli, Long Gwen, Mark Anum, Michael Gann, Michael Late, Naru, Oitz, Pradip Sen, Q216, Radioactive Bullfrog, Revenant Games, Rohit Gupta, Jiang Fam, Verisuta, Will Hoos, Will Polion, Dong Mao Dong, and Chiang Pyongling. So thank you all for watching, and I hope to see you on the next video. Thanks, bye!